Mwah! Mwah! No, 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 no! Enchante! Mwah! Enchante, everyone! Enchante, beautiful people! Mwah! How are you? I am so happy to see you. Welcome back. Welcome back to the Trents channel. Welcome back on this beautiful day in Portland, Oregon. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is back. Like a worn-out family member who has stayed too long. Like an STD when I was 5 years old that just won't go away. It's back. What am I talking about? What could it conceivably be, the Trent? Well, the McRib. The McRib, ladies and gentlemen, it is back. The McRib for her pleasure. Oh, it is back. Oh, guys, I have been waiting for this. For those of you, listen, it is a controversial subject matter here, baby. Baby, it is a controversial subject matter. And before we dive, into it, you need to do something for me, please. During this holiday season of Kwanzaa, of Hanukkah, of Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree, would you please take just a moment, like and subscribe to my channel, hit the little bell for notifications so that you get notified on all of my videos when I upload them. Come here, come here, come here. I love you. Come here. Mwah! So that I can kiss you every time you come on. Every time you come on. Love you. Anyway, can you feel the excitement in the $220,000 sheep? Yes, I'm excited because the McRib is back. And it's back for a limited, as they say, time. You know, didn't it get old? I think they've just passed that up now. You know, remember when they discontinued it and they said, oh, get your McRib now before we it's gone. It's gonna be gone forever. And then they brought it back, then they took it off, then they brought it back, and so I think they're just gonna start just bringing it back once a year, which I'm fine with. And let me give you a little synopsis of what the verbiage is for the script, if you will, for the McRib this year. And not only are we reviewing the McRib for her pleasure, but we are also reviewing the dulce delish frappe. We are going to review that limited time also on this, which is a caramel iced drink with caramel pieces and whipped cream on top of it. Also, when I order, I would also like to present, when I order the McRib for her pleasure, I would also like to be holding the Magnum, the condom of Trent, the official condom of the Trent's channel, even though I don't wear these. Maybe I won't present these when I go up there now, thinking about it. Yeah, we're getting into a weird area here. Couple of reasons. First of all, because that's probably not that cool. And second of all, because it is an empty box. And let's be real, I don't wear these. Okay. Anywho. The McRib. The McRib, ladies and gentlemen. The McRib is back. These are the words exactly from McDonald's, baby. Okay. The McRib is back, dripping. Oh, God. Ooh. Oh, boy. Shirt's coming off. Shirt's coming off, ladies and gentlemen. Especially ladies. Shirt's coming off. You had me at dripping. I'm going to try to get through it. Ooh. Ooh. The McRib is back. Dripping with holiday cheer. It starts with seasoned, boneless pork dipped in a tangy barbecue sauce, topped with slivered onions, crunchy pickles, all served on a home-style bun. When it all comes together, Ladies and gentlemen, it's perfection. And it's only here for the season. So, that is it. Whew. I'm going to need a shower after this. And I'd like you to join me. Wouldn't that be fantastic? Wow. Yeah. Anyway, so we are going to review the McRib. We are going to review the Magnifico. As we speak in French. Dulce Delicious Frappe. And we're going to go through McDonald's. And we're going to order them. And we're going to do that now. Shall we? Anyway, it's wonderful, oh so wonderful, to be in love with you, Marie Chevalier, the great Marie Chevalier saying that. Turn the heat down in here, baby. It's already hot enough in here. Oh, Lordy. Going through the drive-thru ever so gently. So, my beautiful friends, how are you? I am like pumped for this, guys. I got to be honest with you. Okay, I'm being serious right now, okay? It is my favorite item at McDonald's. Let me know what you guys think. I'm being serious now. I'm being the real Trent, being real. I am always real with you, but you know, come on. I love to joke around with you. You know I'm kidding. You tune in because you like, because it's wild, right? Let me know, though, seriously, do you like the McRib or not? We did a review last year. Last year, when I first started my channel, guys, we did a review of the McRib. And I talked about, I think I went off about how I was sick and tired of how they always, like, bring it back and all back and forth and all that stuff. But, so anyway, before I drive up to the drive-thru, I'm going to do a little add-on. Because I reviewed it last year, I'm going to make this how I like it. So I'm going to have extra onions added to it because I love onions. And onions do love me. I'm one of those guys that when I eat onions, I don't really get the bad breath from it. I don't know why. Maybe I do actually. Maybe it's because I'm not kissing myself. Although I would love to. I don't know. You know what I would like to do? I would like to have some onions, and then I want you to come kiss me. I do. And then we'll find out. How about we make that deal? I get the onions, right? You come, and you meet up with me, and then you can kiss me. And you can tell me. Savage. Savage. Anyway, this ought to be a trip. Drive through at the McDonald's, and it's, guess what? It's a McDonald's that doesn't like Trent. It's McDonald's. They hate me here. Oh, they hate me at this one. I think it's because my friend... Yeah. Anyway, that's a story for another time. Let's get up here.
Thank you for choosing McDonald's. Will you be using an
offer code today? I will not be.
Hello, what can I ask you?
Enchante, my dear. Enchante.
Hello,
yes. May I please have the McRib?
Okay.
For her pleasure.
You want the meal or just a sandwich?
Just a sandwich, please.
Anything else?
Could you please add extra onions to that, please?
Okay.
And also, my dear, can I please have the dulce de leche frappe?
Dulce de leche frappe? What size do you like?
Is there a small version of that?
A small, medium, or large?
Yeah, small, please. I don't really need larger than that. Do you have any holiday pies?
Yes, we do.
Oh my God! I did not expect that. I am beyond excited.
Okay, how many do you want?
Has the vanilla pudding in it, right?
Yeah.
I literally just thought of that. I just realized that. Yeah, I'll just have one of them, please.
Okay.
Are you excited? No, that's going to do it.
All right. I think you want to say, I need a pie or something like that. Well, thank you.
What is that, darling?
10:57.
Okay. All right. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
I don't know
bye-bye.
What she said. I'm beyond elated that I forgot the holiday pie last year. The holiday pie rocks! That shit rocks! Nice! Have you, do you, I don't think we did a holiday pie review last time. No. I don't know, I love the holiday pie. So it's just like a pie crust, you know, like, I don't know, I didn't prepare for that because I didn't think that they would have one, guys. I'll ask her about it. Hello, how are you doing, darling?
Thank you, how are you?
Good. I don't even know what the holiday pie is. Do you know what it's kind of like?
It's like, it's a vanilla, like, eggnog.
Vanilla eggnog?
Eggnog flavor.
Vanilla eggnog, and then it's got like a the pie crust kind of thing. They're so good.
I know, it's very good. When you say, oh, you don't know, we have already, I say, maybe he wanna like 5, 10 apple holiday pies, but you want only one today.
Yeah, only one today. I'll come back and get more.
Oh, okay. Let's
see. I do food reviews, so I'm just reviewing one.
Oh.
That's what I do.
Oh, okay. All right.
When did they start? Do they do those right after Thanksgiving?
Yes.
Do
after
they?
Thanksgiving.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. What's your name?
Irene.
I'm Trent.
Nice to meet you,
darling.
Happy
you take care. Happy Merry Christmas to you.
To you.
All right,
happy
darling.
Holidays.
Bye-bye. Happy holidays. Bye. Well, what a sweet lady. She's very nice. Very nice. Very nice older lady. Yeah, so. Anyway. Do I got a receipt here? Yeah. All right. It's itemized. The holiday pie. Are you team holiday pie? I am. I love it. Oh, Enchante, baby, you're very attractive back over there. Very nice Latino looking lady back over here. Hello. Not this one. Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Have a
All right, there's a straw. Thank you, see you later, bye-bye. Not so much that one. Seems nice, but not. No, I don't know why a construction worker vest is necessary, so whatever. But to each his own, right? You know, not the trench type. Anyway, let's get over here. Start the review. Is this gonna be too bright? Oh, the sun is out. Beautiful, beautiful weather here in Portland, Oregon. Is this gonna work? Yeah, this will work. I think this will right. All right, fantastico. Damn it! I had that heater on. I hope that wasn't too loud for us there. So, anyway, Troy the Tray, got him there. Anyway, so, tell you a story, quick Christmas story here. Made a fool of myself again. So, went out for a Christmas holiday dinner with some friends that I hadn't seen in a while. And they're La Charisse friends, right? So, go out, go to a nice restaurant. And they have Christmas music playing, right? So, Christmas music is playing in the background. We're all talking and that kind of stuff. And, you know, it's your typical Christmas music. I don't think that they were playing any Elvis. But they were playing, like, holiday songs. And there was some Rosemary Clooney, which I love. But, man, then... All of a sudden, you know, you hear this, have yourself a merry little Christmas, let your heart be light, right? And I'm like, because it's the, like, Judy Garland version, which there is no other, by the way. There is no other. Don't even attempt to sing that song. If you're anybody but Judy Garland, you have no business singing that song. So, and it's that voice, right? Oh my God. So you hear that, how she does that. If you haven't heard that song, I don't know what world you're living in, but if you haven't heard it, please go play it. If you haven't heard it for a while, go sing it. When she does that, where she does that kind of talk. Whoa, baby. Whoa, man. Even talking about it gets me crazy. So anyway, you know how she does that? Have yourself a merry, you know, that voice. Well, I don't know what came over me, right? That song came over me. And so I'm like trying to like contain myself, right? And I'm all like, apparently, like I'm like blinking excessively and like holding my head back, and like La Cherie is like looking at me, and La Cherie like puts her hand on my chest. Sometimes I'm telling you, the reason I'm telling you this is that I complain about my mom so much, right? I don't complain about her, but I say how like ruffian she is, but sometimes she can be the sweetest lady to me. And I think that, well, I don't think, I know. I think that she saw that I was like, I don't have any qualms in admitting this, right? I don't have any ego that needs to be soothed. She saw the tears rolling down my face, right? I don't know why. That, you know how songs just touch you, how music just affects you? And like I've talked about this, music is like art, it needs to affect you. If it doesn't affect you, don't listen to it, right? And that song, for some reason, and that voice of hers, there's not really, I don't really, Christmas music, I could give it or take, you know, give or take, but just, I don't know, Judy Garland's voice, man. I mean, sometimes on some songs, man, it's just crazy. And I obviously was trying to keep myself but I was also like, you know, freaking out, like stroking out there, you know. And she's like, ah, God, Sherry, I tell you, she's like, darling, you have to calm down. And it just was really kind of sweet. It just was, I don't know, the way she said it was like, and then she said, are you all right? And I said, yeah, I'm all right. And I got myself together, you know. It wasn't like, like, but she could tell, because she knows I like that song. But it was just, it was one of those kind of Christmas moments, and I just wanted to share that with you. It was a Christmas moment between me and my mom. It was kind of beautiful, you know? It kind of was. And I loved it. And so I had my little Christmas moment this year with her, because she put her hand on my chest, and she said, darling, are you okay? And it was beautiful. Man, it made me happy. God loved that little La Cherie. Sometimes, oh, I tell you. But other times, yeah, you know. So be sure you tell your mama that you love her this Christmas holiday. And if you've lost your mama, like I've lost my grandma, that I thought of as my mama as well, just have a nice thought for him. There you go. So, yeah. All right, not going to get too heavy on it, or I will get very emotional. So, anyway, the adults, see, the trend has a soft spot. It's all not just crazy hijinks, right? It's not all just sex. maybe it is. Anyway, we're about to try this. The Dulcel, Delicious Frappel. It's caramel pieces, it's whipped cream, it's flavored syrup. We're going to indulge. And it's iced. Oh, damn. Whoa, that's good. Very, 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 very caramelly. Very caramelly, very robust in flavor. Coffee, of course, coffee, flavored syrup, whipped cream, very caramely, very sweet, very nice. It's nice. Let me tell you the price point on everything here. My McRib was $5.69. My coffee drink was $2.99, limited time. And my holiday pie that we will have for dessert was $1.89. So, and let's take a look at Magnifico. Oh, the McRib. Oh, very saucy. Did not ask. Do you not want to get this all over the Jeep? Do you have some napkins here? Extra onion. There is pickle. Very saucy. So they've added a lot of sauce to it this time. Of the barbecue sauce, The bun is nicely warm. This is a very warm sandwich right here, guys. Feeling very nice. Okay? Let's get right into this. Oh my God, this is messy. Wow, this is. Immediately got the crunch of the nice pickle and the raw onion. Oh man, that's good. Just like I remembered it. Thank God you are back, baby. Thank God you are back. The pork patty, nice and soft, but not soft like it's been boiled. Tender, I don't have an issue with that word. When you're talking about food, it makes me gross, grosses me out. The barbecue sauce is good. Very, very tangy barbecue sauce. Let me try a little, one more bite. Wow. I think I'm, yeah. Yeah, oh, that's good. Very nice. Very nice, very nice. Very good flavor. Well, that's exceptionally good. That is exceptionally fresh tasting. That bread, the bun tasted very nice. The pickle on it was very good. The onions were very good on it. Pork patty was very, very nice on it. Do you have a criticism on it? My criticism on it is, I think there was a little bit too much barbecue sauce on that. The barbecue sauce, I wish, was a little more smoky than tangy, or a little more sweet. It's very tangy. It's a very tangy barbecue sauce. I prefer either a smoky or a sweet barbecue sauce. That, to me, is just a little bit tangy. If I had it again, I'm going to knock it down for that tanginess. And I remembered that last year. I remember it always being a little bit like that. If the next time I have one of those, which I will, and I will recommend it. The next time I have one of those, I'm going to ask light barbecue sauce. That's the way I'm going to order it. Light barbecue sauce, extra onion. So, yeah. On a scale of 1 to 10, the dulce de leche frappé, would I recommend this? Yeah, I would, especially for the price point. I think it's a good drink. On a scale of 1 to 10, I'm going to give this a 7.5. For me, the McRib, I'm a McRib fan. I love the McRib. I am going to give that a solid 9. I would give it a 9.5. if it had less of the barbecue sauce on it, because I don't particularly like McDonald's barbecue sauce. So I am going to give that a 9. So that's what we're doing with that. And now we are going to try the Christmas. Now, first of all, why not some Christmas packaging on this, guys? Where's the Christmas packaging? Okay, I don't see any. There could have been. There's a wonderful decorative Christmas kind of sprinkles on this, like I've had in the past. got the nice, it's nice and warm. It's got the eggnog vanilla custard inside, I believe. Let's indulge. Christmas pie, McDonald's holiday pie. Holiday pie, I can't say Christmas, but I think you can now. Holiday pie, aka Christmas pie. Hanukkah pie, Kwanzaa pie, whatever you want to call it. Holiday pie, we'll call it that. Oh boy. I wonder if they just made this. Oh man. Yeah. Whoa. That's almost too good. The holiday pie from McDonald's, guys, is a 10. That's a 10. This one was. I think they might have just made those. That custard was magnifique. Magnifique. It has an eggnog taste. If you don't like eggnog, you might not like that. It has the vanilla. It has the vanilla combination with the eggnog. The crust on that was freaking amazing. They had to have just made those and brought those out, because those were, I've had those before. Sometimes the crust is real hit or miss on those, because, you know, if they're under a heat lamp, etc. That is magnifique. Magnifique. Scale of 1 to 10. Holiday pie, McDonald's, 10. McRib, 9. Coffee, 7. 7. I'll give it a 7. So, overall, all recommendations. I suggest you try them. I think you're going to like them. And these are all out just for the holiday season. So, get them while you can, ladies and gentlemen. So, well, we're at the end of another video, guys. We're at the end of a video. And I want to thank you so much for being here. I want to wish all of you guys a Merry, Merry Christmas. And a happy holiday season, regardless of what you're celebrating. If it's Kwanzaa, if it's Hanukkah, if it's Christmas. Are there any other holidays that we celebrate around here? I like to celebrate them all, to be honest with you. And I do celebrate them all, to be honest with you. I do. I love Hanukkah, by the way. I don't know what we're doing for Hanukkah this year. I don't know what I'm doing for Hanukkah this year. Yeah, I do, actually. I'll tell you what. I'll let you know what I'm doing. So, anyway. Like the great Elvis Presley said, we will meet you again. May God bless you. Mwah! Adios. I love you. Again, please take a moment. Like and subscribe to my channel. It really does mean so much to me. It does. Almost as much as it does when you leave comments for me. I love your comments. I love when I hear things from you, and I love to write back to you. I answer every single one of them. I do, guys. I don't care how big this channel gets. If it becomes a full-time job for me, I'm going to answer every single comment that you guys ever leave for me. And know that, because you take the time to write me something, I'm going to take the time to write you back, because you're important to me. You're my YouTube family on here. And more importantly, you're my friend. And I think of you that way. And I want you to think of me that way. Because you and I have a relationship. And I love it. So, once again, please, if you haven't, take the time to like and subscribe. And we'll be friends. And thank you so much. And I'll talk to you soon. I'll see you on Sunday for another review. And I'll talk to you later. And I love you. I love you. Bye-bye.